Today we are going to know more about blood circulation and circulatory system. While performing our routine activities, sometimes we get some cuts or wounds. If we get a cut or a wound, what happens? At the site of injury, blood starts coming out or the person bleeds. What is the color and physical state of blood? Our blood is red colored fluid. How long it continues to bleed? Have you ever observed it? Of course, from site of injury, blood does not continue to flow for a long time. Usually, within the time of 2 to 8 minutes, blood flow stops and blood forms a clot. Do you know that the blood vessel or tube which is carrying blood gets a cut whenever there is injury? Our circulatory system consists of blood, blood vessels and a blood pumping organ named heart. Human circulatory system is closed. It means blood flows through blood vessels, that is arteries and veins. On the other hand, animals like earthworm, cockroach have open circulatory system. That means the fluid circulates through empty spaces and not through tubes. Blood or body fluid gets circulated in the body. Along with it, many materials like water, food, hormones, oxygen and waste material are transported. For effective transport of blood in humans and higher animals, heart functions as a pumping organ. To understand role of heart in circulation, let's see a common example. In case of water supply system for a town or a city, there is a pumping station. Here at a pumping station, water from tanks is pumped into pipes under high pressure. Due to the high pressure, water is transported into the various areas and finally reaches our house. Similarly, in case of higher animals, heart pumps out blood which is then transported to various organs. Do you know where is heart located in the human body? Our heart is present in the chest or thoracic region of body, in the center. It is present between two lungs and is slightly tilted to left side. Its size is equal to one's own fist and weighs about 360 grams. Heart is an important organ of our body. Hence, it is protected in pericardium wall. Pericardium has two layers and the space between them is filled by shock absorbing fluid. Our heart is a triangular organ, but it is inverted in position. In the wall of the heart, there are cardiac muscles. These muscles function continuously for heart till person is alive. Hence, they are called involuntary muscles. Therefore, we feel the pulse or beating of heart when person is alive. Now, let us know about the internal parts or structure of heart. Internally, our heart has four chambers or compartments. The vertical partition divides heart into right and left compartments. Each vertical compartment has upper and lower chambers. Thus, finally, there are four chambers. The upper chambers are called auricles or atria and the lower chambers are called ventricles. This was about structure of heart. Earlier, you have studied that there are blood vessels in our body. Normally, arteries open in ventricles and take blood away from heart.
Veins, on the other hand, open in atria and pour blood into the heart. But there is one artery named pulmonary artery that carries deoxygenated blood to lungs from heart. Veins usually carry deoxygenated blood from different organs, but there is one example of a vein named pulmonary vein that carries oxygenated blood from lungs to heart. Arteries and veins are large in size and thick-walled. Oxygen and carbon dioxide can't pass through these walls.
Hence, they produce branches. Artery branches into arteriole and finally capillary. A vein is formed by union capillary and venules.
Walls of capillaries are very thin, hence allow exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide.
Summary. In this video, you have studied human circulatory system. Also, You have studied structure of our heart that has four chambers. Challenge. Human heart has four chambers. How many chambers are present in fish, frog, snake, and parrot?